Good morning to all of you. I am your teacher Asif Saeed Khan. Today we have discussed about the continuous phase modulation or CPFSK and MSK in detail. So for this, the reference book we use is Communication System by Simon Akin, 4th edition. Publisher is John Willey and Sons. So in our previous lecture, we already discussed that what is minimum shift keying. It's the drawback in BFSK, which is in non-continuous FSK. It is noticed that when the input change from logic 1 to 0 and vice versa, there is an abrupt phase discontinuity in the analog signal carrier which is transmitted. So when this occurs, the detector has trouble following the frequency shift. Consequently, an error may occur. This problem can be overcome through the use of minimum shift keying. So in what is minimum shift keying, it is the CP continuous phase FSK signal with deviation ratio is half. So with MSK, the marks and space frequency F1 and F2 are related such that they are separated from the center frequency by in the exact multiple of the 1/2 of the bit rate. So FM and FS is equal to NFB by 2, where N is an integer. So now we are going to detail of these what is CPFSK and what is MSK. So for that we use a reference book, Simon Akin's. So in binary FSK system, we already know that there are symbol 1 or 2 are distinguished from each other by transmitting two different sinusoidal wave that are differ in the frequency by a fixed amount. So typical pair for this is, we describe that signal is SIT under root 2 EB by TB, where EB is our signal energy and TB is bit duration. So it's represent as a amplitude of that signal and cos 2 pi FIT, I is 1 and 2. So there is a two different frequency for logic 1 and logic 0. So here the for symbol 1 signal is represented by S1T and for symbol 0 S2T with frequency F1 or F2, yeah, or either F space or F marks. So the FSK signal described here is known as the Sunday FSK. It is a continuous phase signal in the sense that the phase continuity is always maintained including the inter-bit switching times. This form of demodulation is example of the CPFSK. In this coherent detection of binary FSK signal, we see that the phase information contained the received signal is not fully exploited other than to provide the synchronization of the receiver to the transmission. So now we show that by proper use of the phase when performing detection, it is possible to improve the noise performance of the receiver significantly. This improvement is however achieved at the expense of increased receiver complexity. So in normal CPFSK, we use two signal 2 EB by TB cos 2 pi FIT, but if we use its phase information, then it's we consider it as a continuous phase frequency shift keying signal. So we define it in this term as 2 F1 with theta 0 for symbol 1 and F2 plus theta 0. So where this theta 0 denote the value of the phase at time t is equal to 0, sum of the past history of the modulation process up to the time t is equal to 0. And frequency F1, F2 are the responses of symbol 1 and 0 appearing at the modulated input respectively. So we the another representation of these equation is in the form of angle modulation, which is used in FM and PM. So it's in the angle modulation we express the term in the equation in the term of cos 2 pi FCT plus theta T, where theta T is the phase of ST, where the phase theta T is continuous function of time. We find that the modulating signal ST itself also continuous at all time, including the inter-bit switching times. So this phi T of CPFSK signal increase or decrease linearly with the bit duration TB, as shown, theta t is theta 0 plus minus pi h upon tb t, where this plus minus sign corresponds to the symbol 1 and minus for the 0, and parameter s to be defined. So we substitute this equation into this and compare that equation with the these equations, then we find that the f1 is equal to fc plus htb and f2 is fc minus htb. So what we done, we just put this at here and compare this cos 2 pi fc t plus theta 0 plus minus pi htb with the this equation, then we find that this fi is equal to the fc plus h upon 2tb and fc minus f2 is fc minus h upon 2tb. So by solving these two equations, we get that fc is half of f1 plus f2 and this h is tb f minus f2. So this is called our nominal carrier frequency. It is the just a arithmetic mean of f1 and f2, and the difference f1 minus f2 normalized with respect to the bit duration tb h upon tb is defined as the dimensional parameter h, which is referred as our deviation ratio. So this h is our important parameter in CPFS case. This deviation ratio h is equal to 1, and in minimum shift keying this deviation ratio is half, 1/2. This is the difference between CPFSK and MSK. So then we come to our phase trellis. So in this equation, theta 0 plus minus pi h upon tb upon into t, at that time t is equal to tb, if we put in that equation, then this theta t, this equation comes theta capital tb minus theta 0 is equal to plus minus pi h upon tb. If we put this tb t is equal to tb, then they cut, then the equation is theta tb my equal to theta tb minus theta naught equal to pi h. So here we get plus pi h and minus pi h for symbol 1 and for symbol 0. That is to say that for sending the symbol 1, increase the phase of CPFSK by pi h, and for sending 0, it's reduced by the minus pi h. So in CPFSK, the second phase is changed either plus pi h or either minus pi h. So we already know that we just draw a phase tree. Here is the phase tree diagram. Here we see that this phi t minus phi 0 is in radian is increasing in this manner, pi h, 2 pi h, 3 pi h, 4 pi h, and in decreasing minus pi h, minus 2 pi h, and this is our tree diagram. So where we move as the input data sequences come, which we define now, but before we go into detail what is the tree. So the variation of the phase theta t is time, path consists the sequence of straight line, the slope. So in our phase tree diagram, this tree make clear there the transition of phase across internal boundary of the incoming data sequence we already discussed. So in phase tree, it is our phase tree of CPFSK. So here we see that the deviation ratio is exactly h is unity. So according to this figure 6.27, the phase change over a bit interval is either plus minus pi radian, because h is equal to 1, so either plus pi or minus pi radian. So but change of plus pi radian is exactly same as the change is minus pi radian. So it follow, therefore, there is in the case of just our continuous phase FSK, there is no memory. So that is the knowing which particular change occurred in the previous bit interval provides no help in the current bit interval. But in the case of our special case, where this value of h is half, we now find that the face can make only two values, either plus pi by 2 at odd multiples of TB and only the two values 0 and pi at even multiples of TB. So by this we draw a phase trellis diagram, which is denoted here. Here either is pi by 2, pi or minus pi by 2. So here we see that at this point, odd multiples, it's a pi by 2 or minus pi by 2. At even multiple, it's either pi or minus pi. So in this phase trellis diagram, so it is the second graph, it's a tree like structure. So if we find that the sequence 1 1 0 1 0 0 0 1 means addition of plus pi by 2, or 0 means decrement of minus pi by 2. So here is the diagram for sequence. When 1 comes is, so phase change with increasing manner with plus pi by 2, then again 1 come, it's plus pi by 2, then 0, it decreases by minus pi by 2, then again 1, then plus pi by 2, then again 0, minus pi by 2, then again 0, minus pi by 2, then again 0, minus pi by 2. So this dark line representation of for the incoming sequence of this. So with the h is equal to half, we find that the frequency deviation, the difference between two signal frequency f1 f2 equal half the bit rate. This is the minimum frequency spacing that allow the two FSK signal representing symbol 1 and 0 as in the equation is coherently orthogonal, in the sense that they do not interfere with one another in the process of detection. So for this reason that the CPFSK signal with the deviation ratio of 1 half is commonly referred as the minimum shift keying. So this is the basic difference in between CPFSK and FSK, is the deviation ratio is half in MSK. So next we come to the signal space or constellation diagram representation. So our equation is, what is the equation number 6.109? This is our equation in the angle modulated form, cos A plus B. So we elaborate this equation ST cos A plus B, then we get cos A cos B minus sin A sin B. So we got the two component, in phase component and quadrature component. The first one is our in phase component, in which the this part is our in phase component, which is multiplied with cos 2 pi fct, and second part is our quadrature component, which multiple with the sin 2 pi fct and quadrature of the carrier signal. So in first part we know that with that h is equal to half. So our equation theta t is, if we put the value of h is 1 by 2, then as the equation becomes theta 0 plus minus pi 2tb into t, where the plus sign corresponding to symbol 1 and the minus sign corresponding to the symbol 0. A similar result hold for theta t in the interval minus tb t to 0. So this is for 0 to tb and similarly for minus tb to 0. So except the algebraic sign, which is not necessary for the same of the both interval. So we find that in the interval minus tb to plus tb, the polarity of cos theta tb, the polarity of cos theta tb depend only theta 0, regardless the sequence of 1s and 0 transmitted before or after the t 0. So thus the for this time interval minus tb is a tb, the in phase component consists the half cycle cosine pulse defined as this. So we put the value of theta t as per this equation in here. So cos theta 0 and cos pi 2 tb by t, and this goes to 0. So it's 1, so we get this equation, where the plus sign corresponds to, this plus sign corresponds to theta 2 is 0 and minus sign corresponds to theta 2 is pi. In the similar way, we get for this duration in quadrature component. So in quadrature component SQT, we have sine signal, here we have sine signal. So for that particular duration, we get this formula, where the plus sign signal corresponds to pi by 2 and minus sign corresponds to minus pi by 2. So we get the two equation, SIT in phase component equation and SQT out quadrature phase component. So for this, we find that here is theta TB and here is theta 0 for cos and here for sine. So for this foregoing, so we have the four possibility can arise. First, if theta 0 is 0, if theta 0 is 0 and theta TB is pi by 2, it's corresponding to transmission of symbol 1. If phase phi 0 is pi and theta TB is theta 0 is pi and theta TB is pi by 2, corresponding to transmission of symbol 0. In phase theta 0 is pi and theta TB is minus pi by 2 or equivalently 3 pi by 2 modulo 2 pi, corresponding to the transmission of symbol 1. And the phase theta 0 is 0 and theta TB is minus pi by 2, corresponding to the transmission of phase symbol 0. This is in turn mean that MSK signal itself may assume any of the four possible forms depending on the value of theta 0 and theta TB. So for symbol 1, there is the two combination occurs, when the for symbol 0 there is two combination occurs. So if we expand that equation, this equation, and we just put these two value in this equation, and we'll operate our equation. So we get the in phase component is, our in phase component is this. So if we find the orthonormal basis function, what is orthonormal basis function, phi1t and phi2t of MSK, it's a normal with each other, it not interfere with each other. So from this equation we see that this is the same equation here, which multiplied with the cos 2 pi fct, and for lower part which is multiple with the sin 2 pi fct. So we get these two pair of sinusoidally modulated quadrature carriers. So we may express our MSK signal is S1 phi1t and S2 phi2t. So the coefficient S1 S2 are related with the phase state of phi 0 and phi TB respectively. So we evaluate S1, which is from minus TB to TB, ST phi1t, then we get this under root of EB and energy of bits and cos phi 0. Similarly, S2 we get the minus under root of EB sine theta TB. So from these two equation, we evaluate that the both integral are evaluated for the time interval equal to the twice of the bit duration. Both the lower and upper limit of the product integration used to evaluate the coefficient S1 are shifted by the bit TB with respect to those used to evaluate the coefficient S2. The time interval 0 to 2B for which phase state phi 0 and phi TB are defined is common both in the both integral. So here is the constellation diagram, or we say that the signal space diagram. Here we get 1, 2, 3, 4 message point. So this is our message and two orthonormal function or two quadrature phases, phi 1 and phi 2 is 9 is not orthonormal with each other, and this is the our decision boundary. So and is here is the value of under root EB and minus under root EB, minus under root EB and EB. So here we see that for this message point 1, which is the symbol 0, we know that for symbol 0, phi theta 0 is 0 and theta tb is either minus pi by 2. Similarly, for message point m3 symbol 0, theta 0 is pi and theta tb is pi by 2. And this is for symbol 1 and this is also for symbol 1. So we get the 4 message point for the two symbols, either 0 and 1. So for any symbol, we get the two values. So according from the signal constellation diagram, it's a two-dimensional diagram, n is equal to 2 with 4 possible message, with capital M is equal to 4. So coordinates of the message point are as follow in the counterclockwise direction. Is I first plus EB and plus EB and minus under root EB and plus under root EB, minus under root EB, comma minus under root EB and plus under root EB and minus under root EB. So the possible value of theta 0 and theta TB corresponding to these four message points also include in figure, our previous figure. So this signal sphere diagram is similar as the QPSK, in the both of them have the four message point. The difference is in QPSK the transmitted symbol are represented by one of the four message point, where in MSK one of the two message point is used to represent the transmitted symbol at any one time depending upon the value of theta 0 or either theta TB. So here in the lower we have the signal table which is used for transmitted symbol is 0, the phase state is theta t is 0 and theta tb is minus pi, then the coordinates of message point is for s1 is plus under root eb and for s2 is plus eb and similarly for other. So in this figure we have used the example of sequence 110100. So input sequence is 110100 in the time scale 0 TB, 2 TB, 3 TB, 4 TB, 5 TB, 6 TB and 7 TB. So the input binary sequence is shown in figure A. And the two modulation frequency, we have used two modulation frequency F1 which is 5 by 4 TB and F2 which is 3 by 4 TB, assuming that at time t is equal to 0 the phase phi 0 is 0. So thus phase, the sequence of phase state is shown in this figure modulo 2 pi. So the polarity of two sequence of the factor used to scale the time function phi 1 t and phi 2 t are shown on the figure B and C. So in the top we also show the polarity. So here we see that for phi ktb polarity of s1 if is phi 0 and plus polarity of is plus and if pi minus 0 plus, and for quadrature phase similarly pi by 2 minus, pi by 2 minus, pi by 2 minus and plus. So for symbol, so we just add these two equation, the waveform of the resulting two component S1 phi 1 t and S2 phi 2 t as shown, which is shown in figure, and we get the final this MSK equation which is on the bit to bit basis. So by you combine this we get the MSK equation which is in the continuous in the phase form. Then we come to the generation and detection of MSK signal. Here is the diagram of the generation of our MSK signal. It's called the MSK transmitter. So here we know that the cos 2 pi fct is come and with the in the product modulator. Here we multiply with the cos pi t upon 2 tb where h is equal to half. And it's divided into two band frequencies. First is for F1 and F2. Band pass filter select the frequency F1 and upper side and F2 is lower side. Then the summer is connected. Through that we get the phi 1t and phi 2t orthonormal basis function, and this phi 1t to phi 1t and phi 2t are multiplied with the two binary waves a1t and a2t, both have the bit rate equal to the half of tb. So these two binary waves are extract from the incoming binary sequence in our previous this example. So how we get these two binary waves? So after that we sum that binary, these two binary waves, and get the MSK wave. So we get the MSK signal by using this transmitter diagram, and it is our MSK receiver. So the received signal XT is correlated with locally generated pilka of the our core and orthonormal signal phi 1t and phi 2t. Note that in both cases the integral interval is 2 tb seconds, that is the integration in the quadrature channel is delayed by tb second with respect to the in phase channel. So here we multiply the input with here phi 1t, here phi 2t, here integration is from minus tb to tb, here 0 to 2 tb. So and then here is the decision device which estimate the phase theta 0, estimation of phase theta 0. Here is the phase estimation of theta tb. Finally the phase decision are interleaved so as to reconstruct the original binary sequence with the minimum average probability of error in the AWGN channel. So this logic circuit for interleaving phase decision find the final binary output sequence. So this is the complete of the our continuous phase modulation, either CPFS scan modulation phase shift keying. So thank you all. So it's all for